So we figured that StretchSense sensors save a whole bunch of time throughout the course of a production. But we needed to really get ourselves some nitty-gritty data points to get specific breakdowns of just how much time and where that time comes from when compared to strictly using optical data. So we set out to find out.
With optical, when you're doing finger capture, it's so small that it tends to get lost. You know, the amount of occlusion that happens when you close your fists, or the amount of swappage that happens when your markers get close enough in proximity, there's too much of a margin of error for there, which means a ton of rework and post-work. So we realigned a lot of cameras, trying to give optical the best odds we could.
Here's what we did. Take a complicated, hand-centric animation, create the ideal circumstances for the best optical capture we could possibly do, slap on some StretchSense gloves, and capture simultaneously sensor data and optical data at the same time, not separately. If we did it separately, it wouldn't be a legit one-to-one. And what we found was pretty cool. We guessed there was gonna be a sizable difference, but we're pleasantly surprised by just how sizable. So that's just the raw capture. But we all know that's just the starting line, not the finish. To get a real sense of time save, we took both cases through to a final polish pass. And that's when it got particularly compelling.
As an animator, over time, you can kind of tell what's a good curve and what's a bad curve. You see what they call bluffs, where the data will spike up, have a long period where it's up high, and then spike back down. Or missing data, which results in just no keyframes. There was a ton of that in this capture, and that's because there's a lot of occlusion happening. You know, it's a very complex movement. The beautiful part about StretchSense gloves is that there is no occlusion, there is no swappage, there is no missing keyframes, and so it's all there. And the best part is that we can actually apply it to specific poses so that when those poses are hit, they're in the performance.
When we compared end-to-end time, using the StretchSense solution for hands reduced overall production time by a hefty 76%. This was primarily due to a dramatic reduction in time spent in post.
It's that polish pass that animators go through to really get it to sing, really make it look beautiful. So that polish pass was extensive starting from optical data, but starting from StretchSense data, it was a super shortcut. We saved not just man hours, man days, man weeks on this project.
There was a 72% reduction in time spent on data cleanup and solid 82% reduction in the length of time we needed to complete the motion editing and polish pass to get the animation to final. If you're in the business of creating great hands, our solution will save you weeks of time. And that's what we got. Stay tuned, because we're just getting started.